So first of all, I'll introduce myself. My full name is Ravina Rao. I've been in the training industry for a few years now. I'm Microsoft certified for Excel, PowerPoint. Along with Microsoft products, I also provide trainings on asset management, IT asset management, data protection, and various other Microsoft products. So in today's session, we are going to look at Excel Power BI, Microsoft Excel Power BI. Okay. So when it comes to Excel, now this particular webinar is not going to be fully theory, a little bit in the beginning, and then we are going to move towards the practical aspects. So now here, Microsoft Excel Power BI refers to a suite of business intelligence tools and services developed by Microsoft. These tools are designed to help businesses collect, analyze, and visualize data, enabling better decision-making and business insights. So we live in a world where every day, huge data sets are being generated, be it from your customer or through the internet. The data is getting bigger and bigger in size every single day. The more data you have, the more it becomes difficult for you, first of all, either to clean it, and secondly, to arrange it according to what you want. Whenever you get any kind of data, it might not always be in the format you wanted. There is always some kind of a cleaning required in that particular thing. Now, those who are using Excel a lot, they might know that whenever there is any kind of, you know, data, which is very huge in number, be it about 10,000 or about 20,000, your Excel starts to work a little slow. You get that circle symbol around it, which shows that your data is loading. And sometimes it becomes a little irritating for us to wait for the data to load. Sometimes we also see that the data might not be as accurate when we go with Excel over here. However, the Microsoft has realized that due to this particular thing, they have included certain analyzing tools inside your Excel in order to help you with large data sets. And whenever we have any application which is helping us to sort the data, which is huge in numbers, arrange it, and then we can get the data back into Excel from various different formats. That is what we call as business intelligence tool, which helps me make decisions based on the analyzation which is done by the Excel. Now here, benefits of using Microsoft Excel for business intelligence. The first one is efficiency. Streamline your data analysis workflows and save time with Microsoft Excel's powerful features. Now, in today's world, we see that a lot of people are using Power Query. Now, there are more than three AI tools which have been integrated with Excel. So the first one is Power Query, which is very well into the market right now. Then we also have Power Pivot. After that, now we have ChatGPT as well. Now, one thing to notice in all of these, when it comes to my Power Query does not need me to remember any formulas. It is all about the clicks, and that is what I want. When I'm working with my particular data, the last thing what I want is to remember anything extra, which requires the formulas, this, that, and everything. So in this particular webinar, at the end, we will be looking at the Power Query function of business intelligence. The second one is accessibility. Access and analyze your data from anywhere, anytime, using the familiar Excel interface. So now, inside Excel, I can bring any of my data which is in some other format. So be it in CSV, which is comma separated value, or be it in some kind of a database or Azure, or even another Excel file, I can bring my data, I can import my data from that particular location. Excel is allowing me to do that now. The conversion is done by Excel itself. Flexibility. Customize and tailor your reports and dashboards to meet the unique needs of your business. I know how to create the dashboards. However, the most important part is to how to clean your data. And now here, we are going to see about how to clean your data and how do we go about making the dashboards which are trending right now into the market. key features and functionalities of Microsoft Excel BI. The first one is data modeling. Create robust data models and establish relationships to support complex analysis. So let's say if I have multiple other data with me. I have one table for customer, one table for orders, one table for products. I can create a separate model for all of them and I can combine them into a relationship. And that is how I can get multiple things, the complex things which you see together in one report, making my report more feasible to see what exactly is going on the different aspects of Excel. Now, the next one is, Power Query, import, transform, and clean data from multiple sources with ease. This is what we are going to look at today. Pivot tables, perform dynamic data analysis and generate interactive visualizations. So here, pivot table is something which a lot of us know about. But how deep do you know about it? That's the difference. So when we are saying pivot table, it is much more than just getting your data into fields. How do you put the data? How do you know to generate the proper dashboard or the proper table of how you are looking at it? Understanding the nature of each field when you put your particular data field. How to refresh it so that the data which is present on your table can be linked on real-time basis. All of these things can be done in pivot tables. Now, the next one is data analysis and visualization in Microsoft Excel BI. So the first one is data analysis. Uncover insights and patterns in your data with advanced analysis tools. Now, for those of us who do not want to get into a lot of technical stuffs on this particular Excel, there is one very, very good feature added into Excel right now. And the name of that feature is Analyze Data. You can find that option on your home tab. And what happens in this one is that this particular option of Analyze Data is actually an AI. What do I mean by this when I say that it's an AI? It means I do not have to arrange a single thing. I can just write or type the particular requirement into a box and Excel will generate the results for me. So let us take an example. If I have some kind of a sales data with me and I would only like to see how many of the orders were above 2 million. I can simply type there how many orders were above 2 million. I am not making any coding. I am not writing any formula. I am not doing anything else. I am just typing in a question. Excel here, with the help of Analyze Data button, is going to give me the exact result. That is an AI tool here. That is the business intelligence tool here. Helping me to analyze my data, to generate the results without me having to remember its code or how it works. The next one is data visualization. Create compelling visuals to effectively communicate your findings. So currently into the market, what we see is that every day we see a very advanced level of dashboards coming up. And when we go into any kind of presentations, be it on the formal side or only for the internal teams, we need our dashboards to be that is the first thing that your audience will be impressed by. So it is very important that when you display any kind of dashboards, it looks very advanced in nature. Although it might not require a lot of hassle on the back end, however, it should look very appealing. And that is the first impression which you create when you get your dashboards in. So we are going to look at this particular thing as well. Creating dashboards and reports in Microsoft Excel BI. Design, lay out your dashboards and reports in a visually appealing and user-friendly way. So one thing is that when we use any kind of dashboards, what is the purpose for it? The purpose of me creating a dashboard is that I have a huge data with me. I want you to understand what is in the data. And if I display you with the numbers, it will be very difficult for you. So in this case, I will create a dashboard which speaks the same thing in seconds. It takes lesser time to understand the pattern, to understand what is going on into the data. So it is essential that we use a dashboard which is friendly, which is more understandable. So here, design and layouts are okay. They should be visually appealing, but do not use complex charts when you know that your audience might not understand it better. Interactive elements. Add interactive elements like slicers and filters for enhanced user experience. So if I want to real-time see certain kind of a filter, I can use the slicers in pivot table. Now, this function of slicer in pivot tables are amazing. They can help me analyze the data, filter the data, or see a certain data very fast, very quickly. Now, data refresh. Automatically update your dashboards and reports with real-time data. Now, when I say that my Microsoft Excel business intelligence, it does not only mean that you are generating reports for me. However, when I am updating certain information on my base data, I want that information to reflect on my created dashboards as well, on that particular moment. That is also something which makes my Excel intelligent, or else I will have to create the entire dashboard again. Then what's the purpose of it? If your data is being added daily, you can simply refresh the data and your dashboard will fetch all of the data from there. Integration of Microsoft Excel BI with other tools and platforms. So the first one is Power BI. Combine the power of Excel and Power BI for advanced analytics and visualization. So we all know about Power BI. It makes the analyzing part, the cleaning part, a lot more easier. When the data is huge and if the Power Query is something that you are familiar with, Power BI is something that you will love. It is a little bit more about remembering the features. However, Power BI is extremely smooth when it comes to huge data. SQL Server. Integrate Excel BI with SQL Server for seamless data management and analysis. So for those organizations that have their data stored in SQL Server, Microsoft Excel is also compatible in importing the data from SQL Server as well. SharePoint. Leverage SharePoint to collaborate and share your Excel BI reports and dashboards. Lastly, we have SharePoint here with us, wherein we can share the files or whatever we have created. Case studies and examples of successful implementations of Microsoft Excel BI. Data-driven decision-making. Learn how companies have leveraged Excel BI to make data-driven decisions and drive business growth. Improved efficiency. Discover how Excel BI has helped business streamline their data analysis process and achieve better efficiency. Clear insights. See how Excel BI has transformed complex data into clear, actionable insights for successful decision making. So this was all about my PPT. And now we are moving towards importing the data. Okay. So now this is my plain Excel workbook. This is a fresh new workbook. And now here, I am going to get a file. For this particular webinar, I am using an Excel file. So first, I will go for data tab here. In my data tab, I will look for the option of get data. So when I click here, these are the sources from which you will be able to get your data. From file, from database, Azure, Power Platform, and other resources. So here, currently, I am taking an Excel file. So I will click on From File and the first option here. From Excel Workbook. Then you can search for wherever your particular workbook is there on which you want to work. And you will click on that workbook. So I'm clicking on this one here. And when I select that, I will get this particular window with me over here, which is called as your navigator. And it will tell me the name. When I click here on this particular name, it will show me a preview of what data am I importing. So this is my data kit. This is what I'm importing. So after that, I will click on this button, which is called as transform data. Okay. So before we start working on this particular sheet, let me introduce to you what is this data all about. So the first column which you see here, this is a customer key. The second one is the prefix. The third one is the first name, last name. This is the birth date of my these particular customers who have registered with me. So I have taken certain information from them, from my customers. Taken their birth date, their marital status, gender, email address, annual income, total number of children that they have, education level, occupation, and lastly, home ownership. So this is the data that I've taken from my employees, or from my audience. Now, in this particular data, if you see, let's see on the first one. All the letters are in capital letters here. I don't want that. I want these letters to come in the proper format. What is a proper format? A proper format is your first letter will be capital and rest of the letters will be in small letters. So we'll click here. We will go to transform. Okay, so explaining these four tabs, the first one is the home tab. Therein you will find all of the options which can change the look and feel of your data somehow. Do you want to choose the column? Do you want to remove the column? Do you want to remove the rows, add the rows, and stuff of those nature. The second tab is the transform tab. As the title explains here itself, this particular tab is going to help me transform my data. If I'm looking to edit my data, change the style, increase or decrease the number, get any kind of result associated with my data, always and always I will go for transform tab. The next one is your add column. If you want, you can add a column here wherein your calculations will be done. And the view tab, how your data is going to be, how your data is going to look like. After the after everything is done, if you wanted to look in a specific way, you can come to your view tab. So here, I wanted to convert this particular thing into the proper format. So I've clicked here on the first name. We are in the transform tab right now. And here I will go to the option of format. And if you see here, I have all the options available to me. Lowercase, uppercase, capitalize each word, trim, clean, add a prefix, add a suffix. So let's say I would like to capitalize each word. So when I click here, all of my data is now in proper format. Same thing I'll do here. I will click here, format, capitalize each word, and this is also converted. Now, if you see on the birth date here, there are some dates written over here, and there are some dates written over here. Now, this entire thing looks a little bit messy for me. So if I sit with this particular data on Excel, this will take a lot of time for me to manually go and check which to change, how the format should be changed. This is a lot of work for me. So how am I going to rectify this particular thing? For this one, here, do you see there is something ABC written over here? This is your data type. Always and always, whenever you are working with your data here, you will check what is the data type here. So when I click here on the data type, I will first make it date. Let me change and make this to date. Now, when I change this particular thing into date, this has become into error. Now, again, this is not the proper format. So what I'm going to do is that I will go to file tab here. This is my file tab. I've come here. Options and settings. Then we will go to the options of query options. When you select here, on your query options, you will get this particular window. Now, in this window, you will go to the option of regional settings. When you go to the regional settings, you will see here English India. Let me make it India, no, English US. Yeah. So I am making it English United States. Okay. And now I have the option of refresh preview in my home tab. I have the option of refresh, refresh all. And now this particular data is changed. So not only these functions, you will be able to do a lot of functions in Power Query without the help of your formulas, simply by using clicks. All of the options that you want, they are available to you here in the transform tab as well. It's all about how are you going to use it. I'll give one more example of here. So when I clicked on this particular thing of birth date, I clicked on date and I selected the first option of age. So now when I right click here, I can transform and make it into days, hours or years. How do I want to see their birth date? Total years. And then further, if I right click here and I can round it up. Transform, round up. Because currently this is showing me in decimals, decimal of years. So I will right click here on the title, transform, round up. So now it is showing me the birth date. What is the age of each individual as compared to the current year that we are working on? So this is how you can use your particular Power Query here. Now, currently we are inside the Power Query editor. This is your Power Query editor, and we are inside this particular window. Now, let me click on File, and let me click on Close and Load. So, in this particular way, first, I imported all of my file, all of my this particular data from a folder in my desktop, from the folder on my desktop to Power Query. I cleaned my data on Power Query and now I have brought that data back to my Excel window. It might look a little confusing for those who are new to this. However, you'll get to know this once you get a little familiar with this one. Now, after this particular thing is done, I have my data with me. Now, I will simply go to Insert tab here. I'll simply go to Insert tab here and I will click on Pivot Table. Pivot Table from Table Range. New worksheet. Okay. So, a new worksheet is created over here. So, let me create few of the dashboards now. So first, let me take the education level and the annual income. So I would like to see how much of discount. Okay. So now I'm going to, now from this particular data, it is fetching me the value of annual income. How many times was that repeated for these particular people? So now I'll make a pivot chart out of it. So I'll click on pivot chart, a small, a column chart. I select from this one. And okay. So my first chart is created over here. Now, in the similar way, I will create two more charts. Now, this is my adventure works again. I'll click on pivot table from table range, new worksheet. Okay. Last time I created with education level. Yeah. This time I will create on occupation. This is the occupation and this is their annual income based on their occupation. So I'm choosing pivot chart again. This time, let me take the bar diagram here and open. Let me change the look and feel of this one. And I'll keep it here. Now I'll make one more chart from here. Pivot table, table range, new worksheet. This time, let me take gender. So I'll take gender and annual income. Taken this and pivot chart. I'll take a pie chart for this one and okay. So now let me come to this particular sheet one. Now in this sheet one, first I'll go to view tab. Let me remove the grid lines. I'll select this entirely. And it's a little gray. And now let me take this chart, Control X, Control V, Control X, Control V. I am just taking all of the charts which I created out of my pivot table and I am putting them in this particular new sheet which I created only for the charts. Now, these are my charts. Now I would like to create certain slicers as well. So let me click here, pivot table analyze, and here I will go to the option of insert slicer. What are slicers? Slicers are your filters, which helps you see how do you filter your data. So let me take the homeowner and marital status. So I have taken the slices for these two, marital status and the home ownership. Okay. So these two are my slicers here. Let me reduce the size. Let me give them a darker color. So when the filtering is done, I am aware of it. So now when I click on M, marital status M. So this is only the number of married people. If I click on S, this is only showing me the number of single people. Similarly, if I click on Y, this will show me all of the homeowners. These are the homeowners in these particular occupation. Similarly, those who do not have a home ownership till now. These are the numbers for them. So your filters are used in this particular format. So let me take both of the slicers as well from here and I will put them into my new sheet. So click here, press Control, click here. So both of them are selected at once. Now do Control X. Come to your sheet one, Control V. So these are your slices. Now, if you see here, when I click on M or when I click on Y, only this data is being changed. The other two remain unchanged. So what to do in this case? How do I make these two slicers connect with all the three at once? For that, I will right click here. On my slicer, I will right click here. Report connections. I will click here and I will select all the pivot tables which are here. Same thing to be done for here as well. Right click, report connections, and select both of them. All the pivot tables are selected. Okay. And now let's say I only want to see the data of the people who are homeowners. I'll click on Y and all the three data is changed. So this is how you can clean your data and then you can bring them back to Excel and you can do these particular dashboards which are interconnected with each other on the basis of simple clicks. That was your Power Query, one of the business intelligence tools that we have here. Now, let me show you one very interesting AI tool here. Now, if you remember, this is the data which I cleaned on my particular Power Query editor. I got these in terms of numbers. I made them in proper format, the first name and the last name. Now, in this data, I'm in the home tab right now. This is my home tab. Now, let me go towards the option of analyze data here. Let me click here. So when I click here, a window is loading. This is how your analyzed data looks. Now, let us say I only want to know how many people, from occupation are homeowners. So my question is simple. I just want to know how many people from occupation are homeowners. So this is the output that is generated. It has given me the output on the basis of first name by occupation for homeowner one. So this is your analyzed data. I have just returned here Y and Excel has understood that I am looking for the Y people, those who have selected on Y in the filter. And this is a very small example of how the AI here works with. So this was about your business intelligence tools. And just give me 1 minute. Okay, so when you come, if you would like to see the entire course of what we would be offering into Microsoft Excel Business Intelligence. So what I showed right now, what was a very small introduction about what will the entire course be about. It will show you everything from how to clean the entire data completely, how to create much more advanced dashboards, which are connecting, along with taking filters as well when you're connecting. And much more. So I will be putting this particular course TOC in the chat box. Microsoft Office 365 2021. Okay. So whatever your table is, whatever your data you have, first you will go on your that particular data. In that data, it is essential that you first convert it into a table format. Either you convert it into a table format or you will select your entire data, whatever suits you. After that, you will come to the home tab here. And in your home tab, you will move to the option of analyze data. So when you click here, you can ask or you can write any of your particular questions here. So let's say if I want to ask how many M from gender are Professionals. So I'm just taking the question of how many M from gender are professional. So this is the occupation professional. This is the gender M and F. So I want to know how many men are professionals in this number. So I'll go here and it is giving me the count. Immediately. I hope that was clear. French version of this course, no. Sadly, we do not have right now.
And yes, we have many interesting webinars scheduled for December and as well as January. You can have a look there. Many interesting topics. There is one more topic. Just a second. Let me check the topic. Yes, it is business intelligence with Excel. So it's going to be very, great presentation. So do check our website, get enrolled for upcoming webinars. There are some other webinars based on different topics, different vendors. And there is one important webinar. I think it is relevant for all the developers. Just a second. Yes, the webinar topic is harnessing the power of ChatGPT and Figma for instant HTML and CSS generation. So it's a technical topic. It is relevant for the developers. If you are interested, go check on our website and get enrolled. It is on Monday, 1 p.m. IST. Let me share the link in the chat box so that it would be easy for you to get enrolled. Yes, link is in the chat along with the webinar title. You will get the participation certificate. You will get the LET panel link. You need to log in there and select today's webinar title and download your participation certificate. Guys, all our webinars are absolutely free of cost. There is no charges included here. You can share as much you can and so that others could get benefited by our webinars and gain some knowledge. Yes, we are almost done. Just 5 minutes, I'll wait here. Then we'll end the session officially.